Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing a palette review on a new palette from Too Faced Cosmetics. This is the Peanut Butter and Honey palette. This has been a much anticipated palette, at least for me. I saw a sneak peek on Instagram like months ago and I was like, how can I wait until spring for this palette that is so long? But now it's finally out. I got it at Ulta. They had like a preview for platinum members and I was able to purchase it, so I wanted to go ahead and get it to review. They didn't have many swatches when I ordered it, so I wasn't really sure what to expect, but I have used it a few times, so I'm able to form a pretty good opinion on what I think about it. So here's what the palette looks like. It is definitely amazing packaging. As always, Too Faced just blows packaging out of the park, and like, this is my favorite part, is the honey stands out, and it actually looks like real honey just dripping on the palette. I love that. It actually has cocoa powder in the eyeshadows, and they are supposed to smell like peanut butter and honey. It's really nice. It's very sweet. It's just like a creamy peanut butter smell to me. I really like it. And then if you guys are wondering, here is the shades. It comes with 9 shades here. 3 big shades and then 6 little smaller ones of shimmers and mattes. And the palette retails for $36 and it is available right now on the Too Faced website. I'm not sure if it is on Ulta or Sephora again or yet, or when it's going to be in stores. I think it's going to be in stores like mid to end of March. I have used the palette a few times and I've definitely formed a pretty good opinion on it. I have it on my eyes right now as well if you guys are wondering, which I will tell you guys in the video what I used. But first, I want to show you guys the swatches of all the colors. The shade is Creamed Honey. It's a basic cream, so you can't really see it on me. Next one is Be Sweet. It's a very, very pale pink. And then lastly, I have a satin color called Queen Bee. So those shades are just very, very light. You can barely tell that they're on me. This shade here is Peanut Butter. Obviously, it swatches amazingly. It's an awesome shade. Then I have Honey Brittle. I really like this one as well, this peachy orange. And then that's Honey Buns right here. This next one is Going Nuts. This one, it swatches really nice, but it blends out horribly with a brush. This one is Bee's Knees right there, that more orangey one. Also a little bit chalky and hard to blend. The last shade is called Feeling Nutty. This is another one of my favorites. That brown right there. So as you can see from the swatches, there is some really good shades in this palette, but there also is a few not so great shades. I know the main focus of the honey palette was this yellow. Everyone was like goo goo gaga about it and like, oh my gosh, so excited. I do have it on my lids today and let me tell you, I did have to pack it on my lid about 4 times to get this much payoff from it, which isn't even that much. I do like the look that I have on my eyes. I think it's really pretty, but yeah, that yellow, I really just had to build it up a few times, and then when I tried to put water on it to make it more pigmented, it just kind of like gave my shadow hard pan, and it was really hard to work with, so I had to really scratch it up and pick up a lot of product to get this color payoff, which is not even that super bright. I also want to mention, so the big eyeshadows in this palette are all very light colors. I'm not sure why they decided to include 3 super white cream eyeshadows in this palette, like especially using them for the big shades. You think you could at least make one of them like a nice, like a lighter, like matte brown or something, but they used a shimmery cream, which I did use as my eyeshadow base over my primer. They include a very light pink, which almost looks basically the same on the lid, and then they included satin finish, also cream shade. I just think that 3 base shades is just overdoing it too much. They definitely could have done a lot better with that, because especially if you have medium to deep skin, you're probably not going to use those shades at all. One of the winners of this palette is Peanut Butter. It's a classic shade. It's in 2 of their palettes, I believe. So it's in the Peanut Butter and Jelly palette, if you guys have that one, that little small one like this, and also in the Too Faced Semi-Sweet Chocolate palette. It's a great shade. It's a great matte shade. Blends amazingly. It's just an amazing shade from Too Faced. Then we have Going Nuts, and this one is the darkest shade. It is shimmery, and it's like the only shade that I can use in my outer corner, but oh my goodness, is this one hard to blend. tried to use it in my outer corner and I had to wipe all my makeup off because it looked so bad. It was just like, I could not blend it worth a crap no matter how many times I went in with my brush or added different product to it. It just would not blend. That one was a dud, which sucks because it's the darkest shade in the palette and I like to use the darkest shade to usually do an outer corner color, but oh my gosh, no. Like, I did not like it. So this next one down here, this is Honey Butter. This is also a really good shade from the palette. One of my favorites. I think it's gorgeous. I like to use this one in the crease. I used it a little bit to diffuse my crease today. I think it's really pretty. It's a nice, subtle peachy orange that you could use in your crease or even on the lid. The one next to it, this is Bee's Knees, and I thought that this would be really pretty as well. It has some gold shimmer in it, but it's kind of like a rusty, like, brick, almost like a bricky orange red, and I wanted to use this all over my lid, but when I tried to pack it onto my lid, it was so chalky and dry that it just did not work out. So unfortunately, this one I only like to use, I like to use it smudged under my lower lash line as the color under there, and that's what I put on today. But as you can see, I tried to put water with it and it gave my palette hard pan again, but it is still like hard to blend, kind of chalky, and it has random gold shimmers in it, which don't really show up. And then you guys know I was talking about the Honey Buns, this yellow down here. This one, it's really pretty once you can pack it onto the lid, and it does give kind of like a golden yellow color. But I just wish that it was more, and that it was just more pigmented, and I didn't have to build it up so much, because it's really hard to use that product with water, and it kicks up a lot of product, so that one was kind of a letdown for me. And then this one over here is Feeling Nutty. This one's more of a like a cool toned brown. I really liked this one in my crease as well. That's a really good shade for me. So I would say there's about half good shades and then half kind of not so great shades in the palette. And to be honest, like, I want my palette to be like at least mostly 75% pretty amazing. So yeah, it's just an okay palette for me. I wouldn't say to run out and spend your money on this palette. It is kind of expensive for what you get for $36, and there's just too many duds in this palette to justify the price and to justify getting an eyeshadow palette when there's so many other great ones on the market. I could probably try this a few more times. There's definitely some things I haven't done that I could give it a try, like trying it with a white base on my eyes and trying to like make those bright colors pop, but I still think there's just only a couple looks I can really get out of this palette, and it's unfortunate because it is so pretty and so cute, but I mean, there's a few good shades in here, but just too many duds for me. You guys know I absolutely love Too Faced, and I use their products all the time, and I have nothing against the brand at all, but this palette was just not good for me. Too Faced does have another new palette coming out called the Natural Love palette pretty soon, and it's a pretty big palette, and it actually looks really pretty. Like, a lot of the colors look really pretty and like something I would really enjoy, so I do plan on picking that up too, which I hope it's going to be better pigmented and better quality than the Peanut Butter and Honey. We'll see. They also are coming out with some new highlighters and some new liquid lip shades, so very excited to get those products and review them for you as well. But yes, this product was a miss. It's just, you don't really need it in your life, unfortunately. So hopefully the other new products are going to be better, but yeah, that's going to be it for my review today. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye guys.